So today happens to be one of my favorite days of the year because it's December 5th, and that means it's Disney Day! To celebrate, I'd like to share my story on how I became interested in Disney. A lot of people, when they find out just how much I love Disney, they say, "Oh, you must have watched a lot of Disney movies as a kid." Sure, I did, just like a lot of kids do. But actually, it didn't start until I was in 7th grade. In orchestra that year, we just happened to be playing a score from Pirates of the Caribbean. And I, a 13-year-old, hated it. So I had never seen the Pirates of the Caribbean series at that time, and I was like, this is so dumb. But in this score, there is this one really cool part that I actually enjoyed playing. It goes like this. So I actually liked playing that part, but as a stubborn 7th grader, I wasn't going to admit it. So time goes by, and we're working on this song, and I'm like, okay, whatever, I don't really care. One day, I go home, and I walk into the living room, and my mom was flipping through the channels on the TV, and she just happened to stop on one of the Pirates of the Caribbean movies. It happened to be the 3rd one, which is At World's End. And she turns to me and she says, "Aren't you playing this in school?" And I'm like, yeah. So I sit down and I watch the movie. When it finished, I was like, okay, I guess it was okay. But then the next day, I came back and I watched it again. And the next day, I watched it again. And eventually, I went back and watched the 1st and the 2nd film. And I was hooked. So for a while, I was just into Pirates of the Caribbean, not much else. And then, when I was in 8th grade, I saw the movie Tangled. At that point, I was just really obsessed with Pirates of the Caribbean and Tangled. By the end of 8th grade, we were allowed to audition for a high school orchestra trip that would be traveling to Walt Disney World in the following fall. I passed the audition, and before I knew it, we were on our way to Walt Disney World. It was my very first trip to any Disney park, and when we got there, I ended up meeting Mulan, and she says, "Have you seen Mushu?" And I'm like, "I don't know who that is." The rest of the week was really fun, and it was definitely a trip of a lifetime. But it made me realize how much I didn't know about Disney. When I got home, I started doing some research and just general reading about Disney. So I was gaining all this random Disney trivia, which was great. But then, in 2013, something happened that completely changed my life. I realize that sounds dramatic, but it's true. And the major event that changed my life? Yep, that's right. It's Frozen. And yeah, I know that's funny, but it really did change my life. I've wanted to do music education since I was 12 years old, but when I saw Frozen, I decided to switch gears and go into animation. Aside from being a violinist, I'm also an artist. I love creating jackets, shoes, and wallets. As much as I love animation and art, I did eventually switch back to music education. I no longer focus on art as a career, but it is something that I do for myself as a hobby. And as a huge Disney fan, it makes a lot of sense that I wear Disney clothing. If you have a story on how you became a Disney fan, I'd love to hear it in the comments. Sometimes I still think about how crazy it is that one piece of sheet music changed my entire life. If you're a music teacher, remember that the music you pick is meaningful and has a purpose. With that, I hope you always take the time to pick the best music you possibly can for your students.